What's up, guys? So this is my five pillars to training. When I first started bodybuilding, I really didn't have much guidance. As some of you know, I used to be into other sports such as wrestling. The training's a bit different. What I did was I just went onto YouTube and looked up, you know, some of my favorite bodybuilders and just analyzed and really, you know, studied exactly how they were doing the movements, whether it was like the time under tension with the contractions or whether it was like the rep ranges or the way they kind of position their hands in certain movements, you know, the resting between the sets, things like that. You know, I always tell people that are starting out, they don't have much guidance. Hey, just go onto YouTube and, you know, look up your favorite bodybuilder, whether it's Derek Lunsford or if it's Jay Cutler, it doesn't matter. But that'll definitely help you with your training. So for today, we're hitting arms and really, all of the muscle groups that I train throughout the week, the concept's still the same. I like to start out with like an isolated movement, something that's really gonna target the muscles directly. Nothing too heavy, but that way you're getting the right muscle fibers firing right away and you're not putting it into the wrong muscles is extremely important. So that's what I would consider the warm-up. Typically that's like 2, 3, maybe 4 sets of that isolated movement. So pillar two would actually be more heavy compound movements. At this stage in the training session, you know, you probably have the most energy. This is the time where you can really move some weight and really, you know, tear the muscle fibers without, you know, risking injury. So that's what I would do again, you know, probably like 1 to 2 exercises of that and, you know, 3 to 4 sets per exercise. So the third pillar would actually be more of an active recovery is what I like to call it, where you just got done doing maybe 2 or 3 exercises of a heavy compound movement and you really exhausted yourself, but you don't really wanna just be standing around in the gym and doing nothing and let your muscles just kind of flatten out. You wanna keep them full and pumped up still, but you need to give your body a little bit of a break so you can get that energy back. This would be, again, not as heavy lifting, maybe something, again, isolated as well. So the fourth pillar would actually be the time where you're really busting it in the gym. This is the time where you really get after it. You're pumping up the muscles as much as you can. You're doing drop sets, supersets. You're really you know, exhausting yourself and filling the muscles with as much blood as you possibly can, expanding the muscles as far as you can, really trying to get them to grow. And it, especially if you're in contest prep, you know, this is a great time to burn the most calories right at the end. You know, work it until it's basically you can't get any bigger of a pump. So the last and final pillar to my training would actually be more of just stretch. You know, it's really important that you open up the muscle fibers, letting that blood, you know, rush in there so you can recover. Because as you guys know, recovery is the most important thing. That's why, you know, you drink the protein shake quickly after your workouts. You don't want to be all cramped up when you're leaving. So opening up the muscle fibers, you know, whether it's just laying across the dumbbell rack and, you know, stretching out the biceps with no weight, or if you're just holding weight down to your side, you know, something like that is gonna help really open up the biceps, for example, open up the muscle fibers and let that blood rush in and so you can recover, because it's all about recovery when it comes to bodybuilding. That's my five pillars to my training concept, and that's with anything. Today's arms, but you can apply that to the chest workout, to the back workout, to the legs, in any muscle group. This is how I train. This is how, again, going back to when I started bodybuilding, how I analyze some of these top pro bodybuilders such as Jay Cutler or Ronnie Coleman. This is kind of how I see them training. They just didn't explain it this way, you know? So I'm basically putting out there for you guys, ever since I started bodybuilding, gotten away from the wrestling and other athletics, This is the way that's helped me grow and be the best bodybuilder I can be. I hope you guys really enjoyed it, and I hope you guys can really benefit from it. If you do and you try it out, please comment on there and let me know what you guys think. That's it.